Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech. And yesterday, Apple released WatchOS 7.3 RC, or release candidate, to developers and public beta testers. Now, RC means release candidate, like I said, which means it's the final version unless they find more bugs with it before it comes out to the public. So this should be the same as the public version. Now, it brings a couple new features as well as some bug fixes. So the first thing, though, is let's take a look at the size. And this came in when I was downloading it at 126 megabytes on my Series 6 Apple Watch. So it's not a huge update, but it has some nice, there are a couple nice new features. And like I said, some bug fixes. Apple also released this alongside of iOS 14.4 RC, iPadOS 14.4 RC, macOS Big Sur 11.2 RC, tvOS 14.4 RC, and HomePodOS 14.4 RC. So a lot of new things coming out. We should see all of those released to the public fairly soon. Now, the first thing they've added is a new watch face. And that's pretty much the main reason I made this video, is a lot of people were asking, what's that new watch face? So if I slide over, I already have it set here, and this is called Unity. And so you'll see it says Unity here, and the colors are inspired by the Pan-African flag, and the shapes will change throughout the day. So you'll see here, we have a few different color options as well, but these are the Pan-African flag colors, apparently. And you'll see it says red, black, green, and gold is a color option. Red, black, and green is a color option. And then just black is a color option. When you have it set to black, it is a little bit hard to see. It seems like the display is faded. You may not be able to tell that under this light, but it does seem a little faded. So if you set it to the more colorful colors, it's nice and vibrant. And like I said, the shapes will change throughout the day as you move. Now, you also have the option for two complications. You can set the time or date or battery or whatever you'd like here at the top or bottom. So you have a couple different options there. So I've set them as the date and the battery. So it's really nice that they add watch faces. Maybe one day we'll be able to add custom watch faces, but we have a new option now as well. Now, they've added a new feature, and you can find that under settings. So if you go into your settings, and under settings, if you go all the way down to workouts, under workouts, scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see time to walk. And it says add newest workouts to watch. Time to walk workouts are downloaded when Apple Watch is connected to power and near your iPhone. Completed workouts are deleted automatically. And what this is, according to Apple, is if you have an Apple Fitness Plus subscription, you'll get an audio experience on the workout app where guests share inspiring stories as you walk. So it's just an additional thing. So if you're using walking as, say, a workout or an activity, you go down to your workouts here and you want to set it to maybe go for a walk, an outdoor walk, whatever you'd like. You have some options. And of course, then you'll be able to listen to some inspiring stories if you want to do that, if you have Apple Fitness Plus. Now, as far as visual options, you can see there aren't many more, but they did add ECG in a couple different areas. So if you have a watch that supports ECG, so I believe that's Series 4 or later, you'll have the option now in Japan, Mayotte, Philippines, and Thailand. You'll also get irregular heart rhythm notifications in the same countries as well. Japan, Mayotte, Philippines, Taiwan, and Thailand. So you'll have those options for irregular heart rhythm and ECG. So it's nice that they're adding these to new countries. Unfortunately, countries that don't have it is usually due to Apple having to work with the local government in order to have that enabled. So it does take some time to add that. Now, as far as any fixes they've implemented, well, they did say they fixed issues with the control center as well as notification center, where it may be unresponsive if Zoom is enabled. So notifications and control center may have not worked properly. If you were using the zoomed version, larger text, things like that, it seems to be working nice and fast now. Now, for those of you that are curious, I wanted to show you the build number. So we'll go into settings. The build number should be the same on the public version if Apple does not change it. That's why I bring it up. But if you go into your settings, go to general, then about, you can see at the top, the build number is 18S801. And that version should be the same if Apple doesn't change anything when they release the public version. And I would expect the public version as soon as probably Monday or Tuesday, or as late as Wednesday. But early next week is when I expect them to release that. So look for that. And then also, for those of you that are wondering, this other app that I'm using here. It's called Lumi that allows me to create this watch face. So this is actually showing when the best time to take photos is in the morning and evening. And you can see it says golden hour in 5 hours, 47 minutes, where the sun will go down, and then you'll be able to take some really nice photos. So it just gives you a little bit more information. You'll see sunset, evening golden hour, and solar noon. So that's just this. You actually have to purchase the app Lumi to get this, but I get a lot of questions about that. So again, a new watch face, the new time to walk for Apple Fitness Plus and ECG in a few countries. If you found anything else though, let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on the wallpaper I have on my iPhone, I'll link that in the description as well. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.